Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. This is Operation Hammerfall Part 2. We begin our takeoff preparations.
Pull up. Altitude.
Let's see what they have, oops, in the wind data. 4 knots, 263. Okay, wind is entered. Let's wait for navigation to align, and then we're almost good to go. And navigation is complete. Let's do that. Runway 7. Try not to hit the ground troops. Who are practicing their slow motion. I would love to see a Black Hawk in the arsenal of modules that is currently DCS, which is cool. I just heard today that, or read basically today, that Razbam is working on a Harrier and the A7 Crusader, I think its name is Crusader. And of course the F-15E. F-15E is basically the two-seated version of the F-15C, and it has a weapons officer on board whose job is to do air-to-ground. Let's ask for permission to take off. Gears up. Ab 1. Climb 300. There you go. Ab 1. Combat lights. Rejoin. I should be testing these systems before I take off, but, you know, that takes time and effort and whatnot. Besides, it's usually set to not failure. I mean, usually the missions aren't really set to go anything wrong. So basically the point of testing the bleed air is zero. Or the oxygen for that matter. I've even done missions like 2-3 hours of flight without turning on the oxygen supply, which is it should be essential to not suffocating in this cockpit, but oh yeah, right. I have to check if there is anything. My flight, AMC Overlord 21251. Forward ground strike is 144 AM and 1 LAZ L39ZA recon 144. Okay. So what we'll do now is tune in to that frequency to see if there is anything I can do right now. No, okay. It is usually not a problem that if you don't tune into the radios, but I'm using, well, I'm not using easy communications, so I have to actually tune in to the frequencies, otherwise I won't hear what the mission tells me. So the basically there are triggers if I enter some area or something, then it should trigger the radio speech or whatever. But if you're not tuned to the right frequency, you won't hear it, even if you're correctly in the zone. Warning, autopilot. Why was this set to path? Once I figure that out, I'll let you know. Right, check out our weapons. Mark 82s, GBU-38, GBU-12, two AGM-65Ds, and seven rockets. Okay. I think my wingman has the same loadout, so, and of course the gun. We are still 20 miles out, and from third waypoint is labeled search, so I'm gonna go ahead and guess that when we arrive to waypoint 2 I will get some tasks to look for something. So I'm gonna go ahead and arm my everything. Basically fence in. That takes about three minutes for the Mavericks. So and somewhat similar with the TGP. 2 minutes, 2.5. It is never a good idea to do that in last second, because you will need 3 minutes for the Mavericks to align, and the Mavericks are the most valuable weapons in the A-10 if you don't know, or if you're not good with the CCIP bombing or bombing at all. I, for one, am pretty shitty with the GBU, the Mark 80-12s, and even then I sometimes miss with the GBU-12. 38 is okay, I think. And we have one lousy AIM 9M, which I don't know why we're carrying, because I don't remember any air threats. Let's jump this hill. And Springfield is... I'm gonna go ahead and look. No. Don't go below 17,000 ASL. Well, guys, you set the elevation of the waypoint 3 to 7,000. So, wow. Let's start to climb right now. In case I missed it, let's review. Waypoint 3 marks the probable location of enemy camp. Find it and report it back to Overlord. George of Santana, once enemy forces eliminated, continue along the set flight path to see, be on a lookout for any CLA activity. Okay. So, TGP is aligned now. I am 17 miles out from waypoint 3. I just hope I don't get shot down straight away.
Anfield, this is Ford. We are on station armed with CBUs and bombs, enough to make two target runs.
Okay. Thank you, I guess.
Anfield, this is Pontiac. We are approaching the AO.
Let's go 18,000 just to be sure. We still have 10 miles to go, so...
Field Overlord, copy. Locate enemy camp. Ford is standing by.
Let's see, enemy camp.
Italian enemy encampment at 338 Tango Lima November 214511.
Italic. Yep, copy.
IFF.
Anfield inbound hot. Pickle. Fuck this! Whoa! Dude.
Enfield Pontiac, Charlie Small Camp in the Forest, grid Kilo November 938609er.
Are you sure?
Enfield Pontiac, Tally to track heading southeast, grid Kilo November 9062.
Kilo November is not even here. Shit. No P or Q. Where's Kilo November? I don't really understand. Okay, I'll do one more run just to be safe. Well, that is presuming that anything is still alive down there. Well, I see one soldier that is still alive. Truck as well.
Pull up, pull up. Pull up, pull up.
Okay, so that's that. Let's climb back up to a reasonably safe altitude and continue our patrol. And by reasonably safe, I mean 17,000, above 17,000. You what, mate?
Warning, autopilot.
That might be a glitch. Yeah, I wasn't watching my speed. Fuck off. I got 16,000. Okay, not maybe not 16,000, but at least 10,000 feet to pick up some speed. So, yeah. I hear you. I hear you. Night vision isn't better at all. In fact, it seemed to have made it somewhat worse. Okay, so I'm down to 2 GB AGM-65Ts, 138 and 2 Mark 82s, and 1,000 combat mix ammunition for the main cannon. Too much white, I can't see shit. I don't know where my TGP is. Okay, I'm gonna do... what's that? For the R2B, okay. This is how you cheat when you don't see the enemy and you have a wingman that's AI. You tell him to attack whatever it is he found, and then slave your TGP to his speed. Or hers, whatever. Anything else alive down there? Please put your hands up so I can see you. Thank you. That is Kilo November 3, 930, 609. And I missed what seems like a mile.
Pull up.
Okay, I need speed if I want to make it out up there with the gun run, because it seems that this slope is gonna be heavy to climb if I'm going in from the... That should be the northwest. Miss, what the fuck are you shooting at?
Enfield 4, storage copy, returning to base, board out.
2, join up.
Let's see if you find something. Nothing? Come on. Sure, your eyes are better than mine. Okay.
Warning, autopilot.
I might have missed that one. Never mind. Let's go back. Those must be the trucks, because they are moving. Okay. Let's just say I didn't see you try to hit something with a Mark 82. Something that's moving. What's with the...
Field Overlord, copy that. We will transfer the coordinates to our ally.
So we? Okay. Let's see if we can find any more targets.
Engage targets of opportunity.
That is great news, actually.
Join up.
I got one GBU-38. What do you have? Two... What's that? That's the Mark 82? I think so. And then that's it. Okay. No, you still have a rocket. Okay. Let's just hope we don't have to use them, and then we'll be okay. Let's try that one more time. Correct. If you don't have a JTAC, but you have a wingman, this is how you find your targets. Basically because he will look for them and find them immediately. This is what it does, but I don't think in real life I would be able to spot something from this distance. I mean, really? I can barely make out houses. And I don't think that the standard equipment for an A-10 pilot is includes binoculars. But apropos binoculars, I do have a TGP, but that TGP is also a bit handicapped if it comes to zooming in, because if I zoom in enough, I'll see a segment of the area I'm looking at, and I would have to look every inch of the fields or forests or whatever are there, and that's a huge work. I mean, that's a waste of time basically, because while I'm looking here I could be attacked by anything basically. Well, if I have cap cover then maybe, but that is also a big if. Whoa, 53 miles away. That's a long journey. Let's speed it up a bit. Good thing that there is a advance time or speed up time option in this game. Almost there. Let's check in with ATC. Let's go pattern altitude then, which is about 3,500, 4,000 feet. Absolutely not giving a shit about the air brakes right now. Physics is physics. Alright, if the dive angle is not so steep, then I guess we are going to be slowing down. Alright, slowly but surely we are in within range to land. I think it's about 7 miles out. Should be. Six miles. That's contact tower.
In field, 1-1, request landing.
In field, 1-1, cover ready, clear to land, runway 07, wind 270, at 3 meters per second.
Altitude.
Yeah, fuck that. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. Isn't that just dandy? What's his name? Evax just landed. Or what's that? A standard C-135. Eh, never mind, there was a C-135. So it just landed. We have to go around. Oku or Pado. Okay, I need to lose speed and altitude.
Altitude.
No, don't rejoin. Okay, so this is why it didn't really tell me where the enemy camps were, or when I was done. Maybe there are more in this mission. I just didn't find them. I don't know. Well, this was... this was Operation Hammerfall. And the campaign, The Enemy Within, for the 8th NC. See you next time.